One, two, three, four, five, six. The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitchigoo. Lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and crew was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American sun, coming back from Sunville in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned, including some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. At 7 p.m. it got dark out, and then he said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." Captain Wiring, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. And later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains are the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. Farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. Thank you.
In a rustic old hall in Detroit, they pray in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gajigumi. Superior, they said, never gives up her day when the gales of November come early.